Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? So, Bjornholm ended up being a complete disaster. We were going to make this massive, great, big agricultural enterprise that was going to involve everybody in the town, everybody was going to prosper, and they hated it. They basically drove us out of the town, and we were utterly condemned for it. We sold all of our machinery. We had to sell it all back to the dealer because nobody turned up for the farm sale, so we had a very poor price for that. And I sold the farm. We got quite a bit of money for it eventually, but I lost loads of it in fines. So you can see we have just under $500,000 left. We are now in the States. We are on my uncle's farm, and it's only a very small farm. Nobody was interested in buying it because of the process of expansion. So we've got just under $500,000. This is our new house. We even have a cat. Look at that. So let's just take a look at the cat. There we go. That's Tabby. Hello, Tabby. I like cats. Right. The one thing I did bring with me, though, I did sell it to the dealer, but then I bought it back again, is that one. So I have some other machinery that is off around the sides. We will go and have a look at that. It's not particularly important. But before we go any further, this map is Hard Workin 3. Anyone can buy a field, but it takes a real man to clear and plow it. You start off with a good-sized field, but the rest is up to you. Other properties can be purchased and plowed as you see fit. While using your map as a guide, you can plow your field small, large, or split up your fields for multiple types of fruit. It says, now with pig, beef, and storage, chop straw and GMK. To be honest, I'm not quite certain what GMK is. Someone can tell me, that would be great. Oh, by the way, keep your head low and watch out for crazy Uncle Earl. He hasn't been the same since the accident. Accidents. Okay, so this is Hard Workin 3. And if I just come out of that one, I will go into this one here. And I've got the pig and beef mod. I don't think that the compost, lucerne and clover and oats are actually available in the game. There doesn't seem to be any prices for them. It's just because of the mod that we've got. But we do have pig and beef. And obviously we've got the silage at the biogas plant. This is on hard mode, the same as we have been using. Wheat, barley, canola, corn, potatoes and sugar beet can all be sold. And wood chips can be sold at biomass heating plant. We have a biogas plant as well. They're all here. So this is the map, right? We have this field up here. Let me just go over one. Yeah, we've got that field there, number one. All the rest aren't purchased yet. This map's actually quite big. The fields are very large fields. Before we go any further, though, we want to have a look at the house, because this house is absolutely brilliant. I love this house. Okay, this is something that I've not seen before. We have gold coins. There we go, 99 more ancient gold coins. Look at this, the door opens. How awesome it look at this. I've got a TV, I've actually got a house. I've actually got a house. And this is why I didn't want to do the initial exploration of this place, just sort of introduce it to you. I didn't want to do this as a time lapse. I wanted to actually talk you through it, because this is the first map that I've been in that actually has a house. We've got a television there, there's a photo of our house there. We've got another picture there. Look at that. Nice kitchen. You can go upstairs. I mean, how awesome is this? You even got I got a gold coin in my toilet. How brilliant is this? I love it. Right, there's that one. So this is a house, and we are walking around inside our house, which is something I never thought I would do in Farming Simulator. So it's almost, you know, The Sims. But yeah, our house. I know, I've said it like 36 times already. You're probably saying, for goodness sake, Frith, we get it. It's a house. Who cares? I do, because I'm walking around in it. Okay, anyway, moving swiftly on. There's quite enough excitement for one day. I'm hoping the gold coins actually work in this map, not like the old times one. I probably won't dedicate an entire video to finding the gold coins. We'll just find them as and when. But we have storage area. Now, I love the storage that this map has got. I don't know how fast those conveyor belts are. I'm hoping that they are a reasonable speed. But we have wood chips, potato, sugar beet. We run down here. We've got forage there. which appears to be just the grass, you know, forage straight out the forage wagon. Then we've got chaff. So you got chaff from, that would be chaff from, let me bring this, it actually show me what we got in here. Oh, no, it doesn't. So that would be chaff from, like, maize silage, and then forage from grass silage, I guess. There's the manure pile. You got straight grass there. Then actual silage there. And finally, you got straw there. You got the whole lot. The beef and pig, that is right here in the yard with us. We've got the manure is over here. We don't have any animals yet, but that's the manure. There's the slurry, and we've got a great big silage bay here. So we got the whole works here. And these ones over here, the doors slide open for it. It's actually pretty cool. And we're just going to take a look in here. Number one says house number one. The doors slide open. Don't know which one this is yet, but we will find out. Can I hear anything? Ah, there's pigs. I can hear pigs, so I'm assuming that that's the pig house. And we have a few machines. Let me just cycle through a few of the machines. So we got the Deutz there. What is this? What is this? Crazy looking white stuff. Let me bring that one up. Oh no, that's just E enter, right. Don't actually know what that is. I'm assuming that's like a fertilizer bay or something like that. I don't know if it's actually something that's used in the map or not. I really don't know. We have opening and closing gates on the fields. You can get close enough. If you get dead center, you can open them both together. So we got this one field here. The other fields, hang on, let me just close these gates again. There. Back up a bit. I only got the one. Let's try that again. There, right, so those are closed up. So we've got the Deutz tractor, we've got a New Holland with a front loader, we've got a little forage wagon over there, a Pottinger, we have a small TC590 New Holland combine, which I'll probably use once for the field out there and then get rid of it. We've got a Lamborghini, which is a nice little tractor, four furrow reversible plow, we've got the Flegel Bull trailer, we have, what is that down there? That's a cultivator over there, I don't know which one, and then we got my bad boy here. So we're going to go for a spin now. I didn't want to spend too long sort of getting all excited and showing you the map, but there is a few things that I want to show you, sort of introduce you to it. So we've got that field over there, and if we just bring this up, that is, you can see me flashing up in the top corner, number one. There are 12 fields altogether, various sizes. You've got different places that you can go, but if you look across at field number two, this is why nobody wanted to buy this farm. It's covered in trees, okay? Absolutely covered in trees. Now, I've got this field here doesn't have a huge amount of trees. I can, you know, at least plow up the middle of the field. That is the for sale board, which I actually, let's just go back to that and take a quick look, because that is a little bit different. So you've actually got boards there that are for sale. And there we go. Land for sale, farm sim realty. We work for you. Excellent. Oh, how much is this one? How much is a field? Let's see. Field number two, 269,000. That's half my money. I was hoping to buy some more machinery. One thing that we're going to need to buy, I think, for this map is a Ponzi. I think it's Ponzi. Ponzi Scorpion. We are definitely going to need the old Scorpion. And we're going to... Right, I'm just going to... I know that I'm bombing around fast and it's not realistic, but yeah, that's fine. So you can plow up all of this land and you can sort of deal with it how you like. What's up here? I haven't actually been up here yet. You've got mountains as well, and quite big mountains. Tall roads. Tall roads, tall hills. With steep roads going up the sides of them. You've got the main roads that go up and down. You've got the town. This is a very American looking map. Now, I've never been to the States. I've never been to America. But when I think of small towns in America, I think of the sort of large grid style layout of a town. I don't know. I'm assuming that's kind of typical. See, you've got American flags flying all over the place. You get that in the States. I believe that you people in the States. Oh, that's heating plant where we sell the wood chips. You're very patriotic. You all fly your flag. You sing your national anthem. You don't tend to get that as much in European countries. We tend to just, yeah, you know, we are from this country, but patriotism is a much bigger and stronger thing in the States than it is in other countries. And I get a real sense of America when I drive around this map. You know, the little town with its large square grid style layout. That's a very, very American feel to it. And some might say that's bad, some might say that's good. I'm not going to judge either way. To be honest, I've never been a big fan of this kind of grid layout. It kind of feels too planned. But I come from a country where the town sort of started growing up, you know, 1200 years ago, and houses have just been added over time ever since, whereas a lot of towns in the States were planned right from day one. So you got all this space. It makes a difference. It's a lot more laid out. I mean, people have got nice big gardens and stuff like that, which is really, really cool. So there's sort of pros and cons to everything, I guess. All right, let's spin round on... I guess this is Main Street, isn't it? Is that what you would call the high street in... I think that's what you call it, isn't it? The high street in the States is always referred to as Main Street, isn't it? I think so. I've just gone past a shop again, so I need to pull a U-ey. Oh, there's the shop. I've driven past it twice. Right, so here's our shop, and that is where we will be buying all of our different bits and pieces. I don't know if you have the milk mod on. I don't know if you can disable selling the milk or if it just sells automatically. I wasn't actually planning to do anything with that. Wasn't planning to... Oh, we've got grass here. We could plow this up, I suppose, if we wanted to. I don't think we will. What was I saying? I wasn't planning to... There was something I wasn't planning to do. There's Crazy Uncle Earl's plane. Driving on his airstrip. Excellent. Yeah, I'm not planning to plow up loads of ground. I will be chopping down a load of these trees so that we can get some of these fields. I'm not planning to turn all of the little bits into areas for cropping. I'll probably keep the smaller areas for doing grass with, and then the bigger areas will be available for turning into fields. Because look at this, it's absolutely covered in trees. So we've got to go through with the Ponzi Scorpion first and clear all the trees away before we can do anything else. So we got a biogas plant over this way, and let's just take a quick look on the map. There is a particular place that I'm heading. Where am I? There, yes, that's where I'm heading. This is the right direction. So I'll come down here, we'll just take a quick look at the biogas plant. There's one more bit that I want to show you, and that is all I'm going to do for this introduction. And I know that the episode for the time lapse this week was a lot shorter, it was just a farm sale. But you've got this as well, sort of a little taster of things to come. What have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4 great big bunkers here for silage. Spin down there a little bit. This map is going to be a lot of fun. And when FS17 comes out, obviously I'm going to want to start my regular series on FS17. And I've got two regular maps I'm playing, plus a time-lapse. And what I might do is not do the time-lapse in FS17 for a little while. Right, so we've got this huge, great big tunnel that goes right through the mountain. It would help if I stayed on the road, which is absolutely brilliant. I am going to be using this road occasionally for during the time-lapses. I think that would be really cool, me driving up and down through this road. And then you come out here into a little bit right in the middle of the mountains, come round a couple of sharp bends, and does it go into another? I don't think it goes into another one. I think that's the, yeah, and then you come up to the back of the farm here. So that sort of brings you up from the BGA, is almost a direct road straight from the BGA up to our farm, which is absolutely cool. You've got Primo Meats, is it, down there? I think that would be where we sell our beef and pig, which is just in there. So yeah, we've got loads of stuff on this map. It's absolutely awesome. I love this map. It really is brilliant. It's going to be a major challenge because obviously you've got to cut down all the trees and you've got to do everything else with it as well. So there is going to be a bit of a challenge, and I think I will actually be leaving these gates open permanently because, yeah, just because. It's a bit easier. I think that's about it, really. Just have a quick look. I'll get some chickens this time. I know I did have chickens for a little while in the time-lapse, but then I got rid of them because they were just a nuisance. They were an absolute pain, they were. So we got, there's a grass meadow here. Oh, no. This is the cows. This is where the cows go in here. So I could, or is it? Yes, it is. The cows go here and they go all the way through this. So I can leave these trees here. But I do have the option of being able to drive in and cut them all down if I want to. So where would I, if I was to disable the milk cell, where would I gather the milk? Would I guess maybe from here, would I, or not? I'm not sure. I don't know. I think that's about it, really. I will start the time lapse for next week, and I am seriously, like I said, I am seriously considering not going on to the time lapse as soon as FS17 comes out, but leaving it a month or so until it sort of ironed out a few of the bugs and stuff like that. And I can, obviously, I'll be playing it through anyway on my regular Let's Plays. And I didn't want to do a Let's Play and a time lapse both on the same map. So if there's only two maps available, I will. This is a series that I will keep running because I think this one's got quite a lot of potential. Because we got to cut down all those trees. We've got to go and sell all the trees, then we've got to plough them up. And by the way, last thing, I will be using a large amount... Well, just turn that one off. I will be using a lot of American mods for this one, a lot of American machinery. Because we are now in the States, I will give priority to US-made machinery. So, John Deere and Kenworth trucks, I think it is another one. I've had some requests for Kenworth trucks to be used. What else was it? Something else I was thinking of, it was quite important to say. Well, probably not that important, but I always think it's important. It's probably because I like the sound of my own voice. Yeah, so Kenworth trucks, John Deere's, and... Oh, yes, I know what it was. I had a discussion with someone a little while ago about ploughing and how it's done quite differently in the States. You just don't see moldboards in the States anymore. Moldboard ploughs, I think that's Uncle Earl over there. Just gone down behind the hill. You don't see moldboard ploughs in the States like we do for, you know, most of Farming Simulator, but you use chisel ploughs instead. So what I thought I would do is for the ploughing in this one, I will use a wider chisel plough for ploughing up the grass fields. I think it will actually be better anyway. It's going to be a lot better because when I was ploughing up Bjornholm, that took a long time. And the trail ploughs didn't work very well anyway. So that's something that I will be working on. Where's Uncle Earl gone now? Right, smoke bellowing out from it. I want to see Uncle Earl. What's he going to do? Is he going to come and crash into the farm? He's coming over there. I can see smoke coming out. Here we go. Right. This video has actually gone on longer than I intended it to, and I apologize for that. If you've gotten bored of this and switched off by now, it doesn't really matter because you won't be listening to what I'm saying. Here he is. Oh, this is brilliant. I wonder how many times we're going to see him do this. What's he going to do? Is he going to crash right into my corn? What's he doing? He's gonna crash! Run. Is he gonna make it? Oh, he nearly took my chimney off. Oh, that's brilliant. Crazy Uncle Earl. He ain't been quite right. Oh, that is sensational. What else is he gonna do? I want to see what else he's gonna do now. It looks like he's just disappearing. Okay. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will go... like I said, I'm not going to start the time-lapse this week. I will start the time-lapse next week. It'll be sort of... I know that I've been doing things a little bit different for the last few episodes. I've been doing longer ones and slightly different ones. It's going to go back to kind of my regular time-lapse, which is... between 5 and 6 hours of gameplay, and I can press it down to around 15 to 20 minutes of video. So, until next week, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.